Hi friends, welcome back to another video. This is Hope here, and I'm gonna take you guys on a little tour of the new merchandise at Walt Disney World. Starting off at Hollywood Studios, I had heard there was a new drop of the Little Mermaid merchandise, which we'll see here in a minute, but we can just take in the sights and sounds of Hollywood Boulevard. So up first is this new collection by Joey Chu. It's very reminiscent of the Jared Mariama collection that was released about 2 years ago in the parks, and it's adorable. Some of these pieces do not have their price tag on them, but I am assuming that means that they will fluctuate based on what time you see them in the parks. This puzzle was so cute. Look at all the different represented attractions from Magic Kingdom. There's a lounge fly, there is a spirit jersey, there were some home decor as well. Such a cute collection. These ears are everything! Look how sparkly the bow is. This bucket hat though, this almost came home with me because it is reversible, so it has the embroidery of Cinderella Castle on the front, and then when you turn it inside out, it has the print of all of the attractions. Really close to picking this one up. This was like a candle holder, I believe. It's like a 3D printed candle holder though. So the characters on the train and the giraffe, should we note, were all kind of raised from the edge. So it's very satisfying to the touch. This, I think, is for like a lantern effect. You can put a little tea light or a candle in there and then turn it on and it'll glow through the firework cutouts. So cute. This table had most of the homeware part of the collection, so there were things for the kitchen, for the living room, there was a throw blanket, so you can kind of mix it out throughout your house, which I thought was a great idea. This collection here does come with all four bowls, and I like how they put different ones on the outside so you get to see them all, but they are like a melamine material, so great for kids, not easily broken. This is the mug, one of my personal favorite items of this collection. Again, it has that cool raised detailing with the characters, but then they're each enjoying a different attraction from the Magic Kingdom, which I just thought was so fun. I thought it would be kind of unique as we walk through this merchandise for me to just share my thoughts and opinions of these items as we go through. I hope that you guys enjoy this style of video. I know it's something different than what we normally do, so let us know in a comment down below if you like this format, and we can definitely do it more often. These ears are my most recent favorite that the parks have come out with. They are a metallic gold, and the bow is actually removable, so you can clip it off from the headband and make it Mickey ears, or you can click it back on and make them mini ears, and again, very close to picking those up this day. I actually showed a lot of self-control, and I'm proud of myself, but I think had Abby and I been there together this day, we would have ended up with multiple of these pieces of merch. Here are the new graduation ears for this year. They basically look the same every single year, but they do say class of and then the year that they came out. So this is the class of 2023. The These were some of the new ball caps that have come out. That last one that you just saw with the Winnie the Pooh is all embroidered. This one is all screen printed onto the fabrication, so it's kind of something fun, a little bit different. And this one, wow, it's everything. I mean, look at that glitter. It is just amazing and perfect timing with the release of the new Little Mermaid collection. Speaking of Little Mermaid, I basically just filmed all the Little Mermaid things that I could find, and yes, that is a bag on my arm. I may have bought a pin in that last store. Whoops. Okay, so this is the new Little Mermaid collection released with the film, and there are tons of pieces in this collection, so I won't talk through all of them, I'll just let you enjoy. But I did think they had such diversity in this collection. There is everything from children's apparel, women's apparel, home decor, clothing, toys, literally everything. And I thought they did a great job of mixing different design elements too. So there's some that are very modern and trendy, like there's a belt bag coming up here that I'm low-key obsessed with. And then they had these like cute little crossbodies for the girls in your life as well, or women could totally wear this if you carry very little with you, which is not me. But yeah, really cool diversity in this collection and perfect timing to have them all available in the parks. Let me know in a comment down below, have you guys seen the new Little Mermaid film? As of the time that I am recording this, we have not seen it yet, but we are looking forward to it very much. So let us know, what did you think without spoilers? Let us know what you thought of the new film and if you would be interested in picking up any of these merch pieces for yourself. Look at this spirit jersey. It is tie-dye purple, but it also has the glitter elements on the part of your world on the background. Gorgeous. I'm not really sure what this is. I think it's just a little trinket tray or trinket dish. So you could use it in the kitchen, you could use it in the bathroom, in a bedroom, really anywhere, but it just comes with the lid that is ceramic as well. I thought this was a really cool design idea for a lounge fly. $88 is what they're asking for this bag. I don't know how functional it is with that kind of asymmetric zipper on the front, but fabulous nonetheless. Okay, here is the belt bag I was talking about. I really wish I could have taken it off and tried it on just to show you the size of it. It's like the size of a sling bag, but it is, of course, a belt bag. I was one-handed this day, though, with the camera, and there were no mirrors, so I could not show it on, but it's quite large. This denim jacket was everything too. I did notice a few months back they did have the denim jacket princess collection, and I was really eyeing those for me and Abby personally. There was like a Cinderella, a Tiana, there were a bunch of different princesses, Rapunzel, but I don't believe they had an Ariel in that collection. So this is perfect. And it has the new version of Ariel from the movie. Also this jaw clip, so cute. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking and just let you enjoy the collection, but just imagine me saying everything is so cute, because it really was. I did think it was very unusual that they had all four pops from this collection in one store. I have a feeling they are long gone now, but with the time I was filming this, they did have all four. So now I am hopping onto the Skyliner and heading to the resorts. I wanted to see some specific resort merchandise that has released recently, so we're gonna hit up a few different Disney resorts. So let's take a little Skyliner ride, shall we? So I am getting off at my first stop, and that is Caribbean Beach Resort. This is the Skyliner transportation that kind of breaks off into a bunch of different directions. So you can go to Hollywood Studios, you can go to Epcot, you can go to Art of Animation and the Riviera as well. So I'm stopping here at Caribbean Beach to check out what kind of merchandise they have. And of course, I had to get some of this gorgeous scenery because I literally could have stood here and looked at it all day. Just the reflection of the Skyliner in the water, oh, gorgeous. And look, guys, a Disney bunny! He was really happy to, like, chill by the road this day, and he actually hung out with me for a few minutes before he darted off, but unfortunately I couldn't get him on camera very much, but he hung out a little bit with me, which was very nice. So this is an entire collection of Tommy Bahama collaboration shirts with Disney. I think these are fantastic. Each one has a different design, but take a look at this price tag, you guys. $138 for a button down. I was a little bit shook, I'm not gonna lie. I do think they're really great quality. They did have women's collection and kids collections as well. But yeah, $138 for the button down and $158 for the dress. So these are definitely more of a high-end purchase on your vacation, but really cute designs, and I do love the tropical kind of vacation vibes. This one is so fun. It's specific to the Skyliner resorts, but it also features all of the islands that are represented in the Caribbean or Caribbean Beach. So it has like Trinidad and Jamaica. Really fun with the little Skyliners across. So this is the Caribbean Beach specific merch that we're going into here. So you can kind of see like the ornaments, the pins, and all the goodies that are specific to this resort. After a brief stop at Caribbean Beach, we are heading over to Pop Century Resort. It's a really easy walk back to the Skyliner station, and now I'm getting off at Pop Century. So let's check out what groovy collections they have here. Now we are heading to the Classic Hall. So this is where you can see the merchandise for this resort as well as the cafeteria. I love this resort. It just has some great vibes, not just because it's all retro, but check out these ears. They are made to look like vinyls, I believe, and then it says Pop Century with the 70s floral on it. Amazing. I basically wanted one of everything from this collection. I'm just really feeling it. I don't know what it is about like the retro being in, but man, they did such a great job. I love this ornament. It is reminiscent of the Mickey phone that is in the lobby in one of those cases on the wall. And this one you can take home as a little souvenir of your trip, and it's a Mickey phone. Classic. chillin'. Here's another bucket hat. We are really getting the tour of all of the bucket hats today, and I'm not mad about it, because each one is reversible. Yes, that is a Pixar ball on there, and it is also an onion. Together. Forever. I'm not sure how they picked what to put on this pattern, but you know what? I'm digging it, so it's working for me. This is amazing. It is a little Lotso Huggin' Bear sweatshirt. It is Spirit Jersey brand, so my guess is it's going to be $64.99, $69.99, somewhere in there, even though it did not have the price on the tag. Look at all these Crocs! I thought this was such a fun array of Disney Crocs, different patterns, as well as the Disney Native shoes. These are mostly in kid sizes. I don't think they had any natives for adults, but I love all of these collabs. I feel like it's rare to see this many patterns of Crocs in one Disney store, so I love they had Mickey, Minnie, salad colors, patterns, gibbets, literally a little bit of everything, and I am here for it. I do love this classic Mickey collection that they have at Pop Century. It has a tag that looks very retro, like they brought it back from the 70s and 80s, kind of very similar to the Walt collection that was released for the Disney 50th. So it's going to be kind of difficult in the future to tell if a garment is truly vintage or if it was released within the vintage collection. So I thought that was interesting. So that is it for our little tour of the merchandise at Walt Disney World currently. I had so much fun filming this video, and I hope you guys enjoyed coming along with me. Now I'm just taking the Skyliner back to Hollywood Studios. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, and let me know in a comment if you'd like to see more of this style of video. Abby and I would love to film more of these, and maybe we can get her in here and chat on her opinion of all the merch as well. So I hope you loved it, and we'll see you next time. Bye!